Welcome to yet another edition of Sporting School. On today's edition, we get to visit Wisdom Infant Daycare in Kiwatule, where little ones from the age 3 to age 7 came out to take part in the day's event.
I am here to witness the 10-year anniversary of the Association of Football in Uganda.
In our star of the week, we get to talk to Darlington Kaketo Viani, a pupil with Kaboja Junior School.
How did I get in here?
I let you in.
No.
And in our sports autos, we get to bring you two ex-English internationals in John Terry and Steven Gerrard in an interview. On our quote of the week, your talent determines what you can do, your motivation determines how much you're willing to do, and your attitude will determine how well you'll do it, he added. Go as far as you can, and when you do get there, you'll always be able to see farther. And finishes by saying, the individual who says it's not possible should move out of the way for those who think it's possible. And that was our quote of the week. Welcome to yet another edition of Sporting School. Today we are down here in Kiwatule via Wisdom Daycare, where little ones from the age of 3 to 6 years of age will be taking part in this one-day event. Walk without play makes Nick a dull boy.
At ease.
At ease.
Attention.
It all started with the kids opening the event with a biblical memory verse, national anthem, and a prayer, with a decent crowd amazed by the act from these little ones. The event started off with the jump horse and was followed by the ball throwing, where these young ones had to aim the ball into the different colors going into the bucket in the nearest time possible.
DJ, put it down. Put it down. Let me see. All right, please. Someone come. Someone count for me.
Someone count for me right there. One, two, three. Someone count from here. One, two, three, four. Women nowadays, girls and women, I do not know, but you clap for yourselves, all right?
Thereafter, it went into the castle building with cups followed by the hurdles, where these pupils had to make two rounds jumping over the hurdles and then crawling beneath on their way back and crossing the finish line with the parents cheering on for their kids.
That is what they call not quitting.
Next up was the sacking race, where the participants fit into the sacks and ran off to the finish line before the day was graced with hula hoops that excited everyone who turned up for the event in Kiwatule. The art is to have a soft waist to pull it off.
Look at that.
A wild animal is the world's baddest animal.
I had a decent conversation with youngster in Christabel Naboyondo, a 5-year-old pupil with Wisdom Daycare Infant School, about her life and what she fancies being when she's older, with a couple of funny moments with the sweet princess.
I swim, I buy clothes.
You buy clothes?
Hmm.
What kind of clothes do you buy?
Dresses, trousers, body stockings and vests.
What inspires you in your life? What inspires you? What makes you happy in your life?
Funny stuff.
Funny stuff like what?
Like when you fall down, I just laugh.
When I fall down, you just laugh?
Yes.
Is mommy and daddy here? No?
Yes.
Why?
Because they're in Teacher Priska's house.
Oh, Teacher Priska's house. Tell me, how long have you been at Wisdom?
Like a lot of times.
Are you in baby class, middle class, top class?
Top class.
Top class?
Yes.
I would like to know your favorite food.
Chicken and chips.
Chicken and chips. Is chicken and chips healthy for you?
Yes.
How healthy is it?
Nice.
What do you do to keep fit? What do you do to keep fit? Do you run? Do you jog?
Yes.
I'm saying, what do you do to maintain your health? What do you do?
I run and jump.
Tell me, when you're home, is there anything else you do apart from homework?
Yeah. No, I do homework after I play.
You play at the same time you do homework?
Who?
Who's your favorite teacher?
Teacher Betty.
Teacher Betty. Do you have any favorite friend here? Best friend?
Yes.
Who's your best friend?
Aisha.
Aisha who?
Aisha Gulam.
I would like to know your favorite color. What's your favorite color?
Yellow.
Yellow?
Yes.
Why yellow?
Because I like it.
Because you like it?
Even my shirt is yellow.
But you have a white shirt?
Yes. In my sportswear, I'm in yellow.
In your sportswear, you're in yellow. I would like to know, what do you want to become when you grow older?
I want to buy a guitar and make music.
You want to become a musician?
No, I want to make music.
You want to make music? What kind of music do you want to make?
The ones I like.
Like which ones? Love music?
This were Mango and Shiba.
What do you learn when you're in school? What do you learn when in school? Tell me. What do you learn? Reading, writing?
Reading and writing. And even we sometimes have some hard work like what is a community?
So what is a community? Tell me, what is a community?
A community is a group of people living and working together.
Joshua chapter 1 verse 9 says, remember that I have commanded you to be determined and confident.
Emma Musige Trinidad run us through some of those things she loves about the school as she took part in the day's event.
Anything you've learned since you joined? Wisdom?
Yes.
Like what?
Riddles. Like everything. I learn some simple things, some hard things.
You have friends here?
Yes.
Who are they? Are they boys or girls?
Girls.
Yeah, girls.
Yes.
Do they have names?
Yes.
Who are their names?
Doreen, Aaron, Isabel, and Namagembe.
What do you do in your free time apart from being in school?
I be on my sister's tab.
Trinidad was happy with how she fared as she put it all down to hard work with another youngster, and Jacob satisfied with how he fared during the sock race as he listed some of those things that summed up his day.
My worries as far as picking and dropping.
The head teacher of Wisdom Daycare Infant School in David Kakungulu came out to outline the importance of having a child involved in sport as he thanked all the mothers who turned up to show moral support to their young ones.
Yeah, this event, we planned it way back. We've been training the children the way to go so that when they're grown up, they're able to, you know, become self-reliant citizens. They're able to excel in sports. And so today's event basically was to identify talents of children that we have. Other than, because unless we do these things, there's no way we can help them to showcase their talent. This age, you know, the children come to school with a tabula mind, like a blank disk, which needs to be written on information. So our task is, when children receive that Wisdom Daycare in Infant School, we want them to grow up with all these skills. So our work is to identify what they can do and to help them achieve that potential as far as maybe athletics concern, as far as so many other sports events is concerned, so that they can benefit out of it, and even the country at large, because tomorrow if they win medals, the government will be able to tax those medals, and it is one way of revenue to the country. So that's why we are making sure that at least every year we should hold a sports day for our learners. Today's event has been colorful, and we would have finished all activities, but because our parents came late, we had invited them at 8:30, and we do things according to English setting, but unfortunately our parents are still poor at time management. But my only remarks to them, that next time, while if invited, whether for meeting, whether for sports or speech day, open days, they should endeavor to spare time and come on time, so that we really do things together as a family of Wisdom Deka and Ifan School.
David Kakungulo further stated that Wisdom still has plenty of room for more pupils to come through and be impacted with knowledge as he backed up the less number of dads who didn't show up for the event. And finally, we spoke to Teacher Priska, the assistant to David Kakungulo, who summed it up for us after the day was disrupted by load shedding, as she gave us her reasons as to why sports is so important to these young ones on the day.
I know the majority are happy, though others aren't, because some of their kids have not participated. Yeah, what I urge parents next time, when we communicate time, they should really, really, really keep time.
I am here to witness the 10-year anniversary of the Association of Football in Uganda.
After the break, we get to meet our star of the week in Darlington, Kaketo Viani.
Right, today on Exit, you've got no excuses to get involved and do this workout because it's just 3 minutes long. And we're going to be working on our abs.
Viani, and a session on our fitness segment. And also,
how did I get in here?
Mate, I let you in.
No.
And also, we get to hear from two ex-English internationals in John Terry and Steven Gerrard in an exclusive interview.